We think about the chemistry of beer. So far, we've converted malt into a fermentable sugar that the yeast could turn into alcohol to make beer. To make quality beer, we need to think about techniques. In chemistry terms, we're thinking about quality lab techniques, controlling our environment, and making sure that we control all of the aspects of the creation of beer. Just like in the lab, we want to make sure that things are clean and that there's no contamination. We also want to make sure that we control all of the aspects of the chemical reaction, the temperature, oxygen, and light. If we think about modern beers, there's a lot better control of many of the aspects because there's a lot better understanding of what affects the quality of beer. Just like a lab situation, we need to start with a clean environment. So cleaning your beer equipment in the process is very important. You also have to think about, if I clean my equipment with certain soaps, it might leave residues of chemical that can affect the flavor. So I want to make sure that when I'm cleaning my equipment, that everything is cleanly rinsed. That means that we often want to use surfactants such as TSP, trisodium phosphate, or soda ash, calcium carbonate, that will rinse away and leave the vessels and the containers and the instruments I'll be using nice and fresh. But that's not all we have to do. We also have to sanitize it. Now, not sterilize it. It would be great to sterilize it, but to do that, we're going to have to do it with steam under pressure. What we want to do is sanitize. We want to reduce the amount of any microorganisms there. This came out of the work with Louis Pasteur, that if we could control which yeast variety, the beer quality went up. So therefore, what we want to do is make sure, once all of our equipment is clean, that we sanitize everything. Now, we can do that with chlorine, such as a bleach solution. But the problem with chlorine is excess chlorine will give us that cork taint, or the chlorophenols, that will give us an off flavor. So we want to make sure that we sanitize either with the proper concentration of chlorine or use something like iodine, which will then evaporate and not leave flavor. But it's important that we clean and sanitize, just like in a lab situation. The other aspects we want to control is the environment. One that changed brewing as we know it is the ability to control temperature. If we wanted to brew a lager, we had to have a cold environment, either over the winter or in a cave. Whenever we had the control through refrigeration to control temperature, it really brought the quality of beer up, and it gave us the ability to create lagers year-round. We want to make sure that we control the temperature in a few specific areas. First is during the mashing. Remember that we want to have the right temperature for the right enzymatic process. The second part is during the fermentation. We want to make sure that we control the temperature of fermentation for our yeast to give them the optimum temperature for not only their growth, but also the creation of the secondary flavor components that will occur during the fermentation process. The last part where we need to be careful with temperature is during the conditioning and storage. Any wide ranges in temperature in this area can decrease the shelf life of our beer and give us off flavors, or hazing, which changes the appearance. Oxygen is very important to beer. Oxygen is essential for yeast growth, but too much oxygen during the boil will cause oxidation and off flavors. Too much oxidation after the fermentation process has started will also create off flavors and decrease the longevity of our beer. Oxygen is necessary. We need 6 to 8 parts per million to start a good, healthy fermentation process with our yeast. In the wrong time can cause lots of problems. So one of the techniques that has increased in beer is controlling oxygen, much like we've seen in wine. The other condition is light. Light is not normally a bad process until we've got the beer finished. At that point, light interacts with the components from the hops to create mercaptans. This is called light struck or skunky beer. Mercaptans smell, well, like skunks. The same chemicals that skunks spray are mercaptans. What happened is some of our iso alpha acids that have been isomerized from our alpha acids interact with light and create mercaptans. The mercaptans give us that rotten egg type smell associated with skunky beer. So therefore, if we use the right container, we can decrease the potential of light-struck beer. The other aspects that we want to control is the amount of fermentable sugars. Hydrometers made a huge impact on how beer was created. At one time, if you wanted to make a pale ale, you made it from pale malt. If you wanted to make an amber ale, you made it from amber malt. But whenever the hydrometer became widely used, what it did was allow them to measure the amount of sugar in the solution. A hydrometer just works on density through the Archimedes principle. We can determine the density of the solution, and that gives us an idea of specific gravity of the density of the solution, which can be inferred to the amount of sugar. Now, there's a lot of components in the beer whenever we do this, so it doesn't give us an exact measurement. So in scientific terms, it's just a guesstimate. But we can use that using the original gravity and the final gravity to not only determine how well we're doing in the conversion of our starch into sugars, but also how well the fermentation process has converted those starches in the original gravity into the final gravity. This can give us an estimation of our alcohol content in our beer. In this area, we're just starting to touch the aspects of quality du beer from a technique standpoint. We could take an entire course on just controlling oxygen, or how to use the hydrometer to get the most out of your mashing process. These are the high points that you need to think about whenever you want to make a quality beer, a beer that we all want to enjoy. So use this as a starting point. Again, you'll learn as much in this course as you put into it. So take one of these areas and explore it and become a better brewer.